Mi arrivano notizie che qualcuno vorrebbe preparare la festa di laurea. Mandiamo i carabinieri, ma li mandiamo con i lanciafiamme.
Allora mi rivolgo a voi, ma dove cazzo andate? Dove andate con questi cani che ci hanno la prostata infiammata?
Accompagnato da un cane visibilmente stremato. L'ho fermato e gli ho detto: guarda che questo non è un film, tu non sei Will Smith in Io sono leggenda, quindi passa pa' casa.
Che cazzo di parrucchiere che vanno in casa a giustare i capelli e me? A che cazzo servono? Cioè, ma l'avete capito che utavuto chiudono? L'avete capito che chi cazzo da davanti per sti capelli aggiustati in utavu?
Come ve lo devo spiegare? Non si può stare. A casa.
Domani ti becco, domani! Non pensiate tra anni, domani!
Sono il sindaco, sul mio territorio non si passeggia. Non vi posso impedire formalmente di uscire da casa? Bene, vi impedisco di passare sul suolo pubblico.
Ping pong, non potete giocare a ping pong, andiamo alla PlayStation.
Siccome io sono il sindaco di questa città, in questa città il decreto lo faccio rispettare io.
Quindi, bene, scusa,
se ne devi andare a casa adesso, non voglio le scuse. Tutti dovete stare.
That's right. Mayors in Italy are getting really pissed off, and they're actually stating that coronavirus patients who refuse to self-isolate face murder charges in Italy. Like, this dude in Italy is already facing 12 years for lying that he had the coronavirus and ended up going to get rhinoplasty anyways. And because he lied, he ended up infecting a bunch of doctors and nurses. What a moron. And that's the thing, in this article it says if a careless coronavirus sufferer went on to pass the buck to an elderly person or someone made vulnerable by a pre-existing health condition, then they could be charged with intentional murder and they could spend up to 21 years behind bars and they don't even have to die. Those who carry on with their daily business after knowing making contact with a coronavirus patient could also face the same penalty, as well as those who fail to warn people they have been infected. Then get this, at the bottom of the article it says if someone willfully ignoring authorities makes someone fall ill for 40 days or more, they could face 3 to 7 years in prison. Authorities say anyone who tries to bypass Italian restrictions by lying about urgent reasons they need to move around this country could be charged with false attestation to a public official and could be jailed for 1 to 6 years if found guilty as well. So meaning if you're leaving your house and you're lying about where you're going to and what you're doing. So hope you learned something and that educated you, because that's going to happen soon in America, Canada, and the rest of the world, that people are going to be charged for leaving their houses. People are going to be charged for not, obeying their self-isolation or quarantine. You can be charged for a couple of years. And if you actually have it and you're out spreading it, you're actually probably going to be charged with murder as well. Because like other diseases like HIV and stuff like that, if you cough or spit in somebody's face, which, you know, is totally wrong, you can actually be charged for murder and stuff like that, and you'll actually serve like 20 years. So just keep that in mind. That's going to happen eventually out here and everywhere else. To be honest, I'm already surprised it hasn't, but you know what, our politicians and government are a lot more slack than other countries. The thing is that eventually they're going to get fed up because people are just not taking this seriously and they're out, you know, enjoying this and thinking it's just a vacation time or something. So anyways, let me know your thoughts and opinions down below, and if you can do me a favor, like this video as well as subscribe. It helps me out a lot, and I really appreciate it. So thanks for watching, everyone. Stay safe, God bless, and take care, and peace out.